Well, obviously, for the folks over at Pimlico Racecourse, the Preakness is their Super Bowl. And there's one man in charge of making sure everything is a go for Preakness Day. 11 News, Rob Roblin has more.
This is your event. This is you guys pulling it all together. I may stir the pot here a little bit, but our success rests on you.
Tom Chuckas, he's the man in charge. He's the president and CEO for the Maryland Jockey Club. And Laurel Racetrack and Pimlico Racetrack are his babies. And with that comes the Preakness.
The buck stops with you, doesn't it?
Yes, but as you well know, I'm only as good as the staff I have. There are a lot of people here that go kind of unsung. You've got maintenance crews, you've got track crews, you've got marketing people. All those people are key components in making all this work. It's not one person. It's many people.
Tom took over in 2008. He was one to make the decision to stop allowing people to bring alcohol into the infield on Preakness Day.
In 2009, I think my picture was on the post office as the guy that ruined the Preakness. But I had told Mr. Stronach and some other people it'd take us 3 or 4 years, and look where we are today. It's a better audience. It's a safer audience out in that infield.
One of Tom's jobs is to keep the horse trainers and owners happy while they're here at Pimlico. While we were walking near the stakes barn, we ran into Doug O'Neill, the trainer of the Kentucky Derby winner. I'll have another.
How's the horse doing?
Awesome. He had a great morning this morning. And
he liked the track?
He loved the track. I like the track today, too.
Doug was nice enough to let us take a look at his winning horse.
In the stall here, he's so reserved. He lays down a lot, you know, and yet on the track he's very energetic and you know, he just gives 110% every time you take him out there.
For Tom Chuckas, Preakness is the track's big moment.
The facility is dated, as you well know, and we're limited on certain things, but remember, getting people in, and then when they leave, that's the last experience they have with us, so I want to make it as positive as possible.
And with just 8 days till the Preakness, Tom Chuckas is hoping this will be the biggest and best Preakness ever. Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV, 11 News.